Get ready for the incredible.
The unstoppable.
For the impossible.
And honestly, just like some just plain badassery.
Get ready for some of the coolest stories we've ever told on this channel as we reveal our top 10 list of top 10 amazing people who survived the impossible.
Welcome back to The Hive, everybody. I'm your host, Rachel Fisher.
And I'm Dewey Stewart.
And without further ado, let's get going. Starting off strong with number 10, Vesna Vulvovic. Vesna Vulvovic holds the title in the Guinness Book of World Records as the highest fall survived without a parachute. Before her name was even known worldwide, this Serbian woman was a simple flight stewardess. The 22-year-old became a flight attendant after she discovered a love for travel when she went to England. She joined Yugoslavia's largest airline in 1971, but 8 months later, her life would change forever. After just 46 minutes, flight 367 flying from Copenhagen Airport, the baggage compartment exploded. The plane split in half mid-air and began tumbling from a height 333,330 feet. By some miracle, Vesna was the only survivor of the 28 people who were on the craft. Bruno Honk, a World War II medic, luckily, who was nearby, was the one that found her and kept her alive long enough for help to arrive. It was her screams that brought him to the craft. Vesna sustained 2 broken legs, 3 broken vertebra, a fractured pelvis, broken ribs, and a fractured skull. After over a week in a coma and 10 months in hospital, Vesna was able to walk again, with no memory, however, of what happened because of the crash. Investigators discovered that Vesna had been pinned to the falling debris by a food cart, which may be the reason she survived. The most crazy thing is, Vesna continued to travel after the ordeal.
What a boss! Coming in at number 9, we have Yaha Abdi. Yaha Abdi, who is originally from Santa Clara, California, ran away from home on April 20th, 2014. Abdi left home with quite the ambitious mission. Sadly, his mother was in a refugee camp in Ethiopia, and he was hoping to save her. Abdi made his way to the Minata San Jose International Airport. Once there, he climbed the airport fence, and after lingering for 6 hours, he snuck into a Boeing 767 through the landing gear and was hidden on board. The plane then reached altitudes of 38,000 feet and temperatures dropped to negative 80 degrees Fahrenheit. But miraculously, Abdi was able to survive the crazy flight. How? The sub-zero temperatures and low oxygen levels at such crazy altitudes pushed his body into a state of suspended animation, which let him survive the 5-hour trip. But once they arrived at the Hawaii airport, Abdi was found and was looked after by medics and he was crazily unharmed. That being said, he wasn't able to save his mama. So good on you for trying, buddy, but I do hope one day you get to see her again.
Number 8, Douglas Mawson. Antarctic geologist Douglas Mawson had one of the most terrible experiences while on a polar expedition. One of the worst in history. He, alongside colleague and friend Xavier Mertz and Lieutenant Belgrave Ninnis, attempted an expedition of the South Pole in 1912. They took 3 sleds pulled by 16 huskies that carried 1,720 pounds of food, survival gear, and scientific instruments. 300 miles in, they were making good time, but then strange things started happening. Mawson dreamed of his father, who he later discovered died that day, and they found one of the huskies devouring a litter of puppies that they had. Not unusual for that climate, but still pretty ominous. Then a series of disasters struck. Ninnis, along with his sled, fell to his death into a massive crevice, along with most of their food and survival equipment. After several days traveling and slowly cooking their own dogs, Mertz fell into a delirium and died on January 8th, leaving Mawson alone on the tundra. Meanwhile, Mawson was left alone and he also fell snowblind. As Mawson continued, his feet became walking blisters and he nearly succumbed to several cracks in the ice and practically had to drag himself for miles to get to the base camp. Finally, he made it to base camp on February 8th with barely a semblance of the man he once was. His fight for survival remains one of the greatest examples of human resilience to this day.
Coming in at number 7, we have Joan Murray. On September 25th, 1999, Joan Murray, a 47-year-old bank executive and skydiver, drove to Chester, South Carolina for one of the scariest skydives of her career. Once the plane reached 14,500 feet above the ground, Joan jumped out of the plane only to discover that her parachute was not working. So what did she do? She cut off the defective chute and prepared to deploy the reserve chute. Her reserve chute opened, but it wasn't until she was 700 feet above the ground. For those that don't know skydiving that well, well, that's a really close call. Joan hit the earth at 80 miles per hour and landed on top of a pit of fire ants. The ants bit her 200 times before she was finally retrieved by paramedics. It was thanks to these bites, though, that she was able to survive the shock of the fall, as the reaction to these bites kept her heart beating. She was then rushed to hospital and was in a coma for 2 weeks. She then underwent 20 reconstructive surgeries, 17 blood transfusions, and after 6 weeks in hospital, she was finally able to stand once again. This is one crazy call with death, but Joan made it through. Once again, another one I can't even fathom, and now I will officially never skydive, no matter what and no matter how curious I get. This one is crazy.
Number 6, Mauro Prosperi. Real life is stranger than fiction. Adrenaline junkies will do anything for that rush they get when the stakes are really high, and Mauro Prosperi was no exception. Italian Mauro Prosperi loved to push himself, so he decided to take on the Marathon of Sands in the Sahara Desert, a 6-day marathon across the desert covering 156 miles. Usually there are thousands of people who join for the strength in numbers mentality, but in the year Mauro did it, which was 1994, there were just 134 competitors. A father of three and 39 years old, Mauro did everything he could to prepare, but nothing prepared him for the massive sandstorm on the fourth day. Mauro kept running, and when it passed, he completely lost his way. From a challenging marathon to a quest for survival, Mauro did everything he could to endure. He licked the dew off of rocks, drank his own urine, and indulged in rats, lizards, and bird eggs he discovered in an abandoned temple. Still, with no rescue in sight and days of searching, Mauro became so disheartened he tried to take his own life. But his blood was too dehydrated, it just coagulated too soon, so he was forced to continue. Eventually, he discovered a puddle with enough water to revive him, but he had to take small sips because otherwise it would just all come up. Finally, he was found wandering by a shepherd girl. He lost 35 pounds, weighing in at 99 pounds when they found him, and his liver had almost entirely failed. His survival story has been described as nothing short as superhuman. What's crazy, this is crazy, he went back and he completed it in 2012. This time he stayed on the path and there was no sandstorm, but he actually went back after that.
Coming in at our halfway point at number 5, we have Julianne Kopeck. Julianne went through something that I know Dewey Stewart would never have survived. Julianne was supposed to graduate on December 23rd, 1971, but her mother wanted to fly out on the 19th or 20th. But Julianne disagreed with that and wanted to stay for her graduation. So her mom booked a flight on Christmas Eve instead. Quite horrifically and tragically, while on the flight, the plane was struck by lightning, which nearly fully disintegrated the craft 2 miles above the ground. Julianne stayed strapped into her seat as the plane quickly approached the earth, and she braced for impact. Miraculously enough, she survived with only a broken collarbone and a couple of cuts on her arms and legs. She then survived off a bag of sweets that she found at the crash site and traveled along a nearby stream until she came to a cabin. After surviving 11 days in the jungle, she was rescued by local fishermen and rushed to hospital. Once she was reunited with her father and fully healed, she returned to the crash site to help rescue and recover what they could. She heartbreakingly found her deceased mother who had passed in the crash. I can't even fathom going through something like this, but Julianne did. Julianne, I'm very, very sorry for your loss, but major kudos to you for surviving and helping out the rescue and recovery. That's major respect.
By the way, if you want a part two, because there's actually a lot of really cool stories, let us know in the comments. Make sure to like, subscribe, do your thing. Anyways, number 4, Sir Adrian Carton de Wart. After I'm finished this tale, you'll understand why he was dubbed the unkillable soldier. The only thing that eventually took him was the thing that takes us all, time. De Wart served in the Boer War and both World Wars. Throughout all three, he was, okay, ready? Shot in the face, lost his left eye and hand, shot through the skull, hip, leg, and ear, and he survived. This guy was literally a boss. He was seen pulling pins out of grenades and throwing them with his one good arm during the Battle of the Somme, which, if you don't know, was one of the absolute absolute worst battles between both world wars. Despite the haughty depictions of generals in, say, like Blackadder, he was always on the battlefield serving as a general beside his men, a hero to the highest order. In April 1941, while on a military mission in Yugoslavia, in his 60s, no less, his plane was shot down in the Mediterranean. He survived the crash, swam to shore again, freaking one arm, and then captured by Italian soldiers and put into a POW camp. He then tried to escape and even successfully eluded capture for 8 days, but he didn't look Italian, so it was pretty easy to spot. He was released 2 years later, and Churchill then sent him to be his representative in China. Eventually, the man retired from life on the battlefield and lived out the rest of his days in County Cork, fishing until passing peacefully at the age of 83. Because none of the rest of it killed him.
Starting us off in our top three, at number three, we have Karina Chikatova. July 27th, 2014, three-year-old Karina Chikatova unknowingly followed her father through the wilderness and took off the beaten path. She lost her way and ended up finding herself in Siberia's taiga forest. Both parents, unaware that the other didn't know her whereabouts because of poor network connection in the area, suspected nothing. Karina's mother only realized her daughter had gone missing 4 days after she trekked off with the dog.
4 days?
Four.
4 days?
Is that crazy? Your child is missing for 4 days. Let that sink in. Nida the dog came back after 9 days and assisted the rescue teams in finding the little girl. For the 11 days she was out in the wilderness, she survived off berries and water from the fresh streams. Let me just remind you all, she was 3 years old. So this one is absolutely insane. She was three! She was saved by her dog! This is quite literally an example of a man's best friend confirming the title, and an incredibly intelligent three-year-old. I would have been a goner. I was dumb at three, I'm still dumb now. I would not have been able to do it.
Number two, Anthony Borges. Wow. Anthony not only survived the impossible, he also put himself at risk to save his entire class of 20, which he did. Anthony was a student at the Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School. Some of you may recognize his name for the Parkland shooting, which sadly took the lives of 17 people, with 17 others severely injured, and there would have been more if it weren't for Anthony. When shots rang out on February 14, 2018, Borges used his body to block the door of a classroom, resulting in 5 gunshots going through his body. Thanks to him, over a dozen students were saved, and remarkably, this is the crazy part, Anthony survived. He was shot in the back and his legs as he locked the door and used his body as a barricade. His friend Carlo Rodriguez said in a statement to ABC News, and I quote, "None of us knew what to do, so he took the initiative to save his other classmates," unquote. That is nothing short of heroic. Thank you, Anthony.
And finally, coming in at number one, we have Tim Lancaster. On June 10th, 1990, British Airways flight 5390 took off from the Birmingham airport. The plane rose to an altitude of 23,000 feet when all of a sudden, there was a loud bang. Luckily, it happened just as air steward Nigel Ogden entered the cockpit. Due to extreme decompression, 2 of the 6 windscreens shattered and Tim Lancaster was immediately sucked out of the plane. But Nigel, with his crazy fight or flight response, pun not intended, grabbed a hold of Lancaster's legs as the co-pilot made a descent and called for an emergency landing at Southampton Airport. Yeah, he was holding onto him through the windshield of the plane. Lancaster only suffered a fractured right arm, wrist, severe frostbite, and Ogden dislocated his shoulder, damaged his eye, and suffered frostbite on his face as well. But that's it. Luckily, these two survived this crazy event, but it was later discovered that the windscreens were only installed just 27 hours prior to when the plane took off, and the mechanics mistakenly used bolts that were much shorter in diameter than the standard bolts that they should have used. This one does not help my fear of flying one bit, and this one, it just leaves me speechless. I think I would have actually died from a heart attack or shock before anything else, like, not kidding. But Nigel, freaking bless your soul, and Tim, just wow. I can't. That was our list, everyone. What did you think? What was the craziest one to you guys?
Yeah. Have you heard of any? Let us know in the comments, and let us know if you want to do a part two, and you know how to do that. How do you do that, Dewey?
By putting down in the comments and also liking and subscribing to our Hive.
All right, guys. I've been Dewey Stewart.
And I've been Rachel Fisher.
And until next time,
stay sweet.